All right. How do you feel living outside of your home country for so many years?
I always felt it was temporary, and at some point I realized it was permanent. But I always thought, I'm just away for the time being. But then at some point I realized I actually lived somewhere else.
How do you deal with the repetitive side of your job, seeing the same performance over and over again?
Same way as you. Oh my goodness, you suddenly remind me of Dolores from Westworld. Are you watching Westworld?
No. Is it a compliment? Dolores.
I think so, Dolores, especially when you became serious. Yes, some things are, you know, sometimes you repeat things and things are I don't really deal with it. I just, you know, it's also not constant. Sometimes you watch a show many times and you feel it's repetitive, and then you see the next show, and then suddenly, you know, poof, to totally, you know. You also get more, with time, you get more interested in the interpretations and the actual show. And you start to feel how choreography and the interpretation, where they meet, in a sense.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but the people become more interesting after a while. So, you know, and how they can express themselves through this channel, which is the choreography, or through this medium, which is the piece. So it's not a big deal. It's like, you know, like we're talking now, and there are going to be some highlights and some low lights, and a show is like that too. It's not like 1 hour of a boring show because you've been doing it every time. No, it's, even though it's the same, it's also fresh. So I don't really, you know, and sometimes I'm tired, and sometimes I feel happy, and sometimes I have a lot of energy. So it's even though it's the same show, in a way, it's totally different. Artwork? In artwork?
No, when you're at work, like when you're working in the studio or on stage or with us, what turns you on in your job?
The surprise, I think.
Mm-hmm.
to see, or, you know, things that I couldn't think of, or that stopped my mind, or it's challenging also to work with people, because you know, because a group's made out of so many components, so, and each also, yeah, each individual responds differently to, you know, and you have different relationships with every single person. You know, some are more friendly, some are more professional, some are more cold, some are more intimate. So, but you have to, yeah, it's very, yeah, it's very fascinating, and at the same time, it's also very lonely, because you're kind of, you're not really a choreographer, you're not really a dancer, so you speak to a lot of people and you communicate a lot, but at the same time, you feel a little bit separate also, at least for me.
Yeah.
Because you have to kind of negotiate often between the two.
Yeah. Do you have a memory
buffer,
of a
buffer thing? You're often a buffer.
What's a buffer, actually?
A buffer is like something that, you know, when you have a gun and you put a silencer on it, something that stops something or muffles something or slows down something, or like if you fall on on the floor and you put a mattress, the mattress will buffer the impact to the ground. It's like something that absorbs.
Yeah.
You know, if a dancer freaks out and I report that as is, you know, then maybe upstairs they freak out, and it just, you can very easily create a lot of inflammation. Mm-hmm. And in Benzeva, everybody loves drama. No. So.
Of course. Do you have a moment as a rehearsal director when you gave a correction or worked with a dancer and it was kind of very meaningful for the dancer or for you?
It's hard to say, because often it's hard to see the impact of something you say or do. Like in the moment, it's rarely, actually it's hard to tell. Sometimes you hear something in retrospect afterwards. So in the moment, afterwards maybe it becomes meaningful or not meaningful, but as it happens, I don't really realize when something's meaningful or not. You know, sometimes you say something that's to me so obvious and conventional, but you know, if you're young and you've never heard it, then it's, you know, it can be transforming, maybe, I don't know.
Yeah, for sure.
I think it's important to relate to people where they are, not just simply in where you want them to be.
Yeah.
You know, like, start where you are, because if you know, you need to walk before you can run.